Hello everybody, my name is Jelle and you're watching to my YouTube channel. Today we're back in the field for the first time this year to actually do some work in our plum orchard. Of course we did a lot of other work also, but this is the first video of the year back in the orchard. So we do have a problem with our plum trees, and that they often break off because the plum trees are not that strong wood, and also they are very sensitive for sicknesses. So over the 40 years which this plum orchard is old, you have some trees that die, and this is one example of them. So this one broke off, then we got here some examples. Yeah, it broke off and it started growing again, but that's not productive, so we're gonna rip that out so we can plant some new trees back on the spots. Let's go and get the excavator in the field so we can get started with this. So, restoration so far has worked out great. The gap is working nice. I don't have too much noise in the gap. Of course, on the camera you can hear some noise, but really not bad in the gap for such an old machine. Lunchtime. It's a plum tree in combination with an oak tree. It's really weird because these two are fused together somehow. Let's see if it will start after lunch break. This is the field where we have the Jonah gered. At least at this part we had them. On that part we planted Welland last year. So we decided another 20 rows have to go this year. That way we slowly on get less and less Jonah gered. And that way we can plant more and more new varieties, which will sell better and grow better and require less chemicals. So that's all in a positive way. These trees have all been taken out by people who wanted firewood, so that means they are all out without any work. That's perfect. The only thing that's left now at this moment is that we still have some stumps in the ground at some places, because not all the trees were Unigrat. And the Unigrat, they don't have stumps, as they are very weak trees, which produce a lot of apples. But this other variety was the Zari in this field, and they produce some stumps, and they're also a generation older. And we left the Zari in this field because the Zari was a delicious apple which was selling enough to us. But we decided to throw them out now because we still have another corner of Zari which is enough for what our market requires. So what we're gonna do is we bring out the mini excavator into the field and we will dig out all the tree stumps with it so that way we don't have to shovel it. So for road traveling now, I prefer to have the 956 in front of it, as it is a heavy excavator. I haven't driven it on the road yet with this trailer. So having a decent tractor in front of it is definitely something that I would like. I'm having an issue. The fuel pump is not pumping diesel up. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna wire this back again straight onto the fuel filter. And later on I can install a new fuel pump when I get back home again. So this way I should be able to get out of the row, as I'm like in the middle of the row. And there's nothing I can do with the excavator in the field here if it doesn't run. So I just need an emergency way to get it running. That way I can get home, and if it runs nice, I think I will try to finish up this row so it will be finished and loaded up on the other side so we can fix the fuel problem at home first. So let's see if we can fix that. Okay, the issue is a little bit different than I expected. This is the fuel hose which is coming from the fuel tank. As you can see, I can just hold it down. Nothing comes out, but the fuel tank is full. So it means it's plugged somehow, which is really weird. But I can't get it unplugged by blowing in it. So I'm gonna use an extra hose here on the outside. So that way I can still get fuel into the engine, I hope. So the fuel pump does not seem to be the main issue. So let's see what it does. We got diesel again. It's running, so that is already a good thing. Fuel problem temporarily solved. And everything is going perfect now. So I just keep going like this until I'm finished. And then we load up and we head home again. And once we're home, I can find a fix for this problem. I think some kind of mess or maybe rust came loose in the tank, because I did flush the tank a few times when restoring it. And yet I got a hose which is plugged. This is my bypass going into the tank here and then going into the fuel pump back there. So I don't want to leave this here when we go to other jobs. I just want to get this job finished this way. I was able to clear the complete job with a temporary fix. As you can see, all the stumps are out. There is still here and there some Yonex Red stumps, but the difference is they are tiny stumps and these they are quite heavy. So it's good to take these out with the excavator. For the other ones, the few that are around in the field, it doesn't make sense to drive around with the excavator. Besides that, there is prunings everywhere. So I don't want to drive through every row before we have shredded them anyway. So let's load up the excavator and call it a day. It's late and it's weekend. So we will go on next week.